But we
No,
didn't
we
need
pressure
for
the
mother.
family. We
Mother
spray
help
his
we didn't
water.
need. Yeah, I'm too using this this box, but
Okay.
we need more medicine like iota, etc.
Yes.
So this is being a great loss.
So considering the
Normal
incubator and the
incubator also being great plus. I'm not blaming you. Normal incubator also being great loss. For 14,000, it's a great loss. For 14,000, we may buy a mother hens.
So when considering only 10 to 15 hens or small farmers, we can go with that. But incubation industries, they can't buy all the for 15,000 egg slots. They cannot buy such 15,000 mother hens and they can incubate and they can see to that hens, right? So they ultimately turn into an idea of incubation or hatchery machines. So our product ultimately fits to that machines and it leads to high productivity and low wastage.
Yeah, your product is just within the normal incubator. You included the mobile application,
Yeah,
mobile incubating
because
system.
I've in the cost structure, I have detailedly mentioned that the normal incubator cost and the smart incubator cost. So when we shift for
Yeah,
smart
the normal
incubator,
incubator cost is within just 2,000 plus, but for just a mobile application, it's costing 14,000.
no, it is not 2,000 plus. The 2,000 plus cost is only for a small amount of eggs. So I am talking about the 2,500 egg units. So that I have mentioned
Yeah,
as one
I
lakh.
can need the 2,000 plus incubator box. I can need more than 1,500 eggs, which is
Yeah.
just difference between 1,000. So I
Yes.
can buy within 14,000. I can buy 7 boxes,
For not
which
two
is
thousand.
which
2,000 is not
Harish,
the
2,000 plus,
it is not
2,000
the
plus.
calculation. Egg production. So
Harish,
capacity
it
of.
is. Wait. Harish, this is not the calculation. You can use it repeatedly now. So
Yes,
just
sir.
you can't say that it is not only for that 1,500 eggs. It's not like that.
Yes, sir.
Continuously.
Normal incubator also reusable, sir.
Yeah, reusable only, but you just don't calculate 1,500 x and this much cost. You don't compare like that, okay? His
Okay, sir. Thank you.
justification is right, I think. Mr. Gautam, justification is right.
Thank you.
Yeah,
Harish.
thank you
Thank you,
thank
Gautam
you
Raj.
sir.
Thank
Thank
you.
you, Gautam.
One point to Harish. That my 2,000 that is only the capacity of X I have plus short. That is not the cost of that small incubator, sir. So it is that for 2,000 capacity egg, normal incubator cost around 1,000 or 1,70,000, sir. You can also serve in the net.
Yes. Okay. Sir, Sandeep sir.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, Gautam Raj. Very nice presentation. Okay. Okay. You have some. I think you may have some plenty of field work and plenty of field work you have to do. Okay. Nice presentation. Anyway, it's going to be useful for.
My industry.
Yeah, all the incubators.
Very
Okay.
yeah.
Those who are maintaining incubators, it will be very useful. Your presentation
Yes.
nice with and your PPT also very nice. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you for this opportunity also,
Okay.
sir.
And then next one is medical application based on WSN, that wireless sensor network. That is Anthony, Sagarika and Navita and Sravani, whether you are available in the meeting. Medical applications based on wireless sensor networks. P. Sagarika, ECE from Beltec University. Whether you are available. P. Navita and Sravani. Medical application based on wireless sensor networks. P. Navita, P. Sravani, P. Sagarika. Whether you are available in the meeting? No. Okay. Next one, students' team name, product title, Rotan refrigerator, Snega third year, Senduran third year. Electronics and Communication Engineering Department from Karpam College of Engineering. Whether you are available in the meeting?
Yes,
Yeah.
sir.
Share your
Yes, sir.
presentation.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Yeah.
Good morning to one and all present here. I'm Sneha from Karthagam College of Engineering, ECE, and I'm and my team member Senduran from Karthagam College of Engineering, ECE department. We have done a project on a rotten rustic refrigerator. One of the smarter devices we use in our day-to-day life is refrigerators. We use in the modular kitchen to prevent the food items. To prevent the food items from being rotten, we have developed this type of project. Our project is developed by giving an alert to the user if the vegetables kept in the refrigerator exceeds the expiry date to minimize the wastage of vegetables and the other food items stored in the refrigerator. Some container food items and juices are also being monitored by initializing an RFID module. The new item is then given a unique RFID tag for identification. Reader module can be stored at extremely cold temperature in electrical freezer at a rate of minus 180 degrees Celsius. As we have explained, this project is mainly to give a reminder regarding the expiry dates we have used. Atmega 328P microcontroller with an inbuilt WPRO, LCD and buzzer to identify the time period of each vegetables and other food items to deteriorate to reduce the expenditure of vegetables and other food items by reducing the wastage. This is the block diagram of our project. Ultrasonic sensor and reader module are the inputs to the Arduino. One of the main components in our project is RTC and it is also an input. Buzzer and LCDs are used as outputs as they are also used for alert, to give an alert to the user. I hand over to Senduran to represent the upcoming slides.
Good morning, one and all to present here. These are the components we have used in our project. Arduino UNO, it is an is used as microcontroller based on microchip. Atmega 328P, ultrasonic module, generally used for finding distance value and obstacle detection. It can operate at the range of 2 cm to 400 cm. Reader module, EM80 RFID reader module, which reads the ID information stored in the RFID tag. Each tag have a 12-digit unique ID. DS1307 RTC is a serial interface. This provides clock and calendar with a second, minute, hour, date, month and also year. We all know that LCD display, which is used to printing values and strings in embedded applications. Buzzer is used to alert the user. The software used in our project is Arduino IDE. This is our circuit diagram of our project. The main component is RTC reader module and ultrasonic. We have to remove the TX pin of our reader module while we dump the program. Working of our project. Rotten rustic refrigerator is powered by 5-volt power supply. The LCD1 display is placed over vegetable and LCD2 display is placed over tin. The ultrasonic detects the vegetable if it presents, else there is no vegetables. It displays no vegetables are available. After the vegetables are placed, we have to manually set the date and time for the vegetables. Once the vegetable exceeds the expiry date, an alert is intimated through the buzzer. Each soft drink is attached with an RFID tag in which each tag have specific identification. After the soft drink is placed, here also we have to manually set the date and time for the drink. Once the soft drink is exits the expiry date, it gives a buzzer alert to the user. This is our experimental setup of our project. Conclusion. Our project can be used in households and also in hotels to reduce the wastage of food items. Future work. We have planned to set up our project as an IoT device so that the user will get an information through mobile while we are not in our home. Demo.
So we'll show a demo of our project.
Okay.
Yes.
we set the manual time for 30 seconds.
Okay, sir.
Okay, Sneha, I have a lot of doubt. I can ask one or two things. See, some packed items you are keeping inside the refrigerator, am I right or not? Or some manual items?
Sir, packed items.
Each and everything you are going to sense. By the barcode or the RFID?
RFID, sir.
RFID. RFID, each and every packing you have to keep. Huh?
No, sir. Soft things we have to attach the tag, sir. Then only it's reached.
RFID tag, eh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Soft drinks, which is borrowed, I mean, get it from the shop or the we are making something now.
So we get it from shop and then we attach.
Suppose if you are preparing the things means.
Sir, if we are preparing also, we can attach it, sir, and we can know, sir. This is the due date for each item.
Yeah.
We can set it manually, sir.
See, what I'm telling, each and every item we have to program and store.
No, sir, then the time and date only we manually want to store, sir.
This particular item.
Yes, sir.
I have a lot of confusions.
Participants, do you have any questions?
Hello, sir.
Pranav Kumar. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a doubt, sir. Actually, whether this this device is for sensing packed foods or unpacked foods, sir?
Senduran. Sneha Nedudelian. Hello.
And the first trail வந்துட்டு நம்ம ப்ளேஸ் பண்ணனியோ அல்ட்ராசோனிக் சென்ஸ் பண்ணனியோ நம்ம வந்துட்டு மேனுவலா டைம் செட் பண்ணனும் 2 டேஸ் னு. அது வந்துட்டு வெஜிடபிள்ஸ்லாம் வந்துட்டு அல்ட்ராசோனிக் ட்ரேல வந்துரும். RFID அந்த டாக் வந்துட்டு சாஃப்ட் ட்ரிங்க்ஸ்ல வந்து.
ஆனா இப்போ வந்து வெஜிடேப் அந்த இப்போ டொமேட்டோ நீங்க சொன்னீங்க 2 நாள்னு. ஆனா அந்த டொமேட்டோ ஏற்கனவே அது பறிச்சு 2 நாள் ஆயிருந்துச்சுன்னா அது நமக்கு எப்படின்னா தெரியும். பிகாஸ் இப்போ நீங்க சொல்றது வந்து நம்மளா தான் கொடுத்துக்கிறோம், அதுக்கு இன்புட் கொடுக்குறோம், 2 டேஸ்க்கு அப்புறம் நீங்க அதை வந்து அலாம் கொடுக்கணும்னு. பட் ஆல்ரெடி அது ராட்டன் ஆகிற ஸ்டேட்ல உள்ள இருந்துச்சுனா
அது வந்து நாங்க நெக்ஸ்ட் லெவலுக்கு வந்து அந்த வெஜிடபிளோட கண்டிஷனையும் சென்ஸ் பண்றதுக்கு வந்து எப்படின்னு நெக்ஸ்ட் லெவலுக்கு கொண்டு போகலான்னு இருக்கும்.
கார்பன் டை ஆக்சைடு லெவல் கண்டுபிடிக்கிற மாதிரி வச்சு நெக்ஸ்ட் லெவல்ல
போறோம். ஓகேனா ஓகேனா. தேங்க் யூ.
ஓகே.
ஓகே. ஓகே ஸ்னேகா அண்ட் செந்தூரன் நைஸ் பிரசன்டேஷன். ஓகே. தென் தி நெக்ஸ்ட் பேட்ச் டீம் நேம் ட்ரிப்பன் IoT பேஸ்டு ஸ்மார்ட் ஃபிட் டு எலக்ட்ரோலைட் கண்ட்ரோல் Bharat, Gladson Bernard, Harish K.
Yes, sir, I am available.
Sri Iswar College of Engineering.
Yes, sir.
Share your screen.
Sir, is my screen visible, sir?
Yeah, visible, visible. IoT based smart feed for electronic trip on. Okay.
Okay, sir. Good morning, everyone. Today, I'm going to explain our project IoT based smart feed for electrolyte control. And our team members are Bharat N, Harish K, and myself. And our team is mentored by Mr. M. Vivek Kumar, Assistant Professor, Sri Iswar College. So what is the problem? Usually the electrolyte bottle or IV saline bottle is controlled manually and monitored manually. So the nurse has to check their watch and adjust the roller to set the drop rate. So what problems can arise? If the medicine is empty, then reverse blood flow can happen, and at times air bubbles can enter into blood vessels and it may cause some trouble. And manual monitoring is not so efficient because nowadays we know hospitals are flooded with patients, and in this corona situation the patients don't have their family support. So if they want to take something, they have to do they on their own, and they have to check the electrolyte bottle at regular intervals to avoid these kind of problems. So we have designed an IoT solution which can monitor these electrolyte levels and trigger an alert to the nursing department that the electrolyte is going to be empty. So please stop these electrolyte bottles. So our surveillance says that our product can be fitted to hospitals and smart health clinics, which includes government hospitals, private hospitals, and and other hospitals as well. So gap analysis. There are lot of manufacturers for manufacturing electrolyte bottles, but no one is manufacturing these kind of monitoring systems. So our solution is to design a portable attachment which can be attached to the stand of the electrolyte bottle, and based on the unique key, the monitoring system will know in which room the electrolytes is currently running and the status. And if nobody is blocking this electrolyte bottles using the roller, the automatic system will block the electrolyte flow in the tube by using a servo. So this is a block diagram. Firstly, we use a load sensor and IR sensor to detect the weight and drop rate of the electrolytes by using the drops in the chamber. And the sensors and the processor which we are going to use is NodeMCU, and the NodeMCU will keep on monitoring the electrolyte level, and if it goes beyond a threshold level, it will give a buzzer sound and it will intimate it to the nursing department. And if it goes beyond the threshold rate, the stepper motor will be activated and it will stop the electrolyte bottle. And an alert message will be given to the nursing department. So technology stack which we are using is smart tuning technology. These electrolyte bottles in the drop rate are depending upon the medicines, the drop rate can vary. So the drop factor can be 15 ml or 20 ml. So we will give provisions to set the drop rate. And the monitoring is done via IoT and core modeling. To design the chamber, we have used a 3D printed model for the initial stage of development. And it is designed using Creo modeling design. And this the circuit design, it is the initial stage of our development. So value proposition which we offer is, it will definitely, it will avoid the reverse blood flow and the easy alert and messages. It will reduce the pressure on the nursing department, so they can sit and relax. The portable and replaceable attachment, it is very portable and it is rechargeable. So if the device is not working, they can very easily attach another device. So customer segments, we are planning to give this our device to hospitals, and it is also useful for patients who are in their homes, because in the homes they may not get that care which they get in hospitals. So our device can be useful for those people. Sustainability, our project is a compact attachment, easy to use and replaceable, and low cost solution. Thank you.
Participants, do you have any questions? Participants, do you have any questions? Participants, do you have any questions?
Sir, can I?
Yeah. Okay. Proceed. வாங்கிட்டேன் வாங்கிட்டேன் போயிட்டு வந்துருங்க, நான்
பாத்துக்கிறேன். இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு ஐடியா வந்து இனிஷியல் ஸ்டேஜ்ல வச்சிருக்கோம். இதை விட பெட்டரான சொல்யூஷனுக்காக வந்து இப்போ ரிசர்ச் மாதிரி பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கோம்.
தேங்க் யூ. எதை யூஸ் பண்ணிருக்கீங்களா?
சென்சர் வந்து இப்போ நம்ம வந்து டிராப் ரேட் அப்படின்னு ஒன்று இருக்கு. இப்போ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லைட்ல இப்போ நீங்க பாத்தீங்களா, இப்போ ஒரு மேல ஒரு பாட்டில் மாதிரி இருக்கு, கீழே ஒரு சேம்பர் மாதிரி இருக்கு. இப்போ அந்த சேம்பர்ல வர டிராப்பை வச்சுதான் வந்து டிராப்பை வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணுவாங்க ஒவ்வொரு மெடிசனுக்கு தகுந்த மாதிரி. மெஜாரிட்டி வந்து டிராப் ஃபேக்டர் வந்து 20 இல்ல 15 வச்சிருப்பாங்க, இல்ல சம் எக்ஸ்ட்ரீம் கேஸ்ல ரொம்ப சிவியரா இருக்கிறதுக்கு வேற ஒரு மெஷின் யூஸ் பண்ணி அந்த டிராப் ரேட்டை கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணுவாங்க. இப்போ இந்த டிராப் ரேட்டர், இந்த வர்ற டிராப்லெட்ஸ் வந்து ஒரு ஐயர் சென்சர் மூலம் கேப்சர் பண்ணி நம்ம வந்து ஆக்சுவலா கால்குலேட் பண்ணலாம். இப்போ வந்து இப்ப 250 ml, இந்த ஒவ்வொரு டிராப் விழுந்தும்போது அந்த 250 ml கம்மியாயிட்டே தானே வரும். ஸோ நம்மளால ஈஸியாக வந்து இதை கண்டுபிடிச்சிட முடியும் எப்போ இந்த ஹோட்டல் வந்து க்ளோஸ் ஆக
போகுதுன்னு. அவங்க என்ன சொன்னாங்கன்னா, இப்ப அந்த பாக்கெட் வந்து ஆல்ரெடி வேக்கம்ல தான் சீல் பண்ணிருப்பாங்க. சோ வந்து அந்த அதுக்குள்ள எலக்ட்ரோலைட்டை தவிர வேற எந்த காத்து அந்த மாதிரி எந்த ஆப்ஸ்டக்கல்ஸும் இருக்க சான்ஸ் இல்லை. பட் எப்படி நான் நீங்க ஆக்சுவலி நீங்க காத்து ஏர் வந்து பாடிக்குள்ள போகாம இருக்கதா நீங்க வந்து
அது வந்து இப்போ நம்ம இப்போ இந்த எலக்ட்ரோலைட் பாட்டில் ஃபுல்லா முடிஞ்சிருச்சுன்னா நம்ம பாடியில் இருக்கிற பிரஷரை விட அது கம்மியாயிரும்ல. ஸோ அப்போ வந்து பிளட் வந்து அந்த வழியாக போகிறதுக்கு சான்ஸ் இருக்கு. ஏர் பபிள்ஸுங்கிறது வந்து ரொம்ப எக்ஸ்ட்ரீம் கேஸஸ்ல தான் ஹேப்பன் ஆகும், எப்பவுமே ஹேப்பன் ஆகாது. பிளட் ஃப்ளோ வந்து இப்போ நம்ம மானிட்டர் பண்ணாமல் விட்டுட்டோம் அந்த மாதிரி இருந்துச்சுன்னா அது வந்து ஹேப்பன் ஆகலாம். இப்போ வந்து ஸ்பெஷல் நீட்ஸ் இருக்கிற பசங்க, இப்போ குழந்தைங்க அந்த மாதிரி இருக்கவங்களுக்கு, இப்போ கொரோனா அந்த மாதிரிலாம் வந்துச்சுன்னா ஃபேமிலி மெம்பர்ஸ் யாருமே இருக்க மாட்டாங்கல்ல, அவங்களுக்கு வந்து தெரியாது அந்த ரோலர் வச்சு பாக் பண்ணணும் அப்படிங்கிறது.
முடிச்சிடலாமா?
Yes, sir.
Team name Sanjay & Co. Project title online penalty payment for traffic violation using RFID and image processing. Sanjay, Barnidharan, Prasanth and Vishnu Deepak from MSc, Kongu Engineering College. Okay, start your presentation. Participants, don't call me. Share your message WhatsApp. Don't call me. Right. Participants, don't call me.
Sir, is it audible, sir?
Yes, it's audible. Barnidhan, you are from Kongu Engineering College. Your department is MSc Engineering.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, can you begin, sir?
Yeah, start.
Yes, sir. So, good afternoon to all present here. Our project is online penalty payment. Our team members are Sanjay S, Barnidhan J, Prashant N, and Vishnu Deepak, myself, Prashant N. Okay, in India nowadays many road accidents are happening. The major reason for road accidents are traffic rules violation. 2018, Bengal government reported about 1.5 lakh fatalities in road accidents. About 11% of fatalities happened in 50 cities of India, which have a population of more than 10 lakh people. To avoid such a traffic violation, our traffic police have also been involved in getting fined. For example, the Delhi traffic police collected a total of 6.4 crores as a traffic violation fees in 2017, while in 2018, the figure went up to 105 crores. Yet the number of people violating the traffic rules also kept increasing. So the main problem here is increased accidents. The traffic jam is more, and the burden of traffic police and chances of bribe of traffickers. The current method involves traffic policemen collect fine on the spot, continuous CCTV monitoring, number plate register is noted manually, sometimes it causes injury to policemen while noting the number manually, and the chances of policemen involved in corruption. So our solution is as follows. Our idea is to design a system to monitor traffic violation using RFID tags and image. Radio frequency identification, that is RFID tag, is mounted to the vehicle, which is as same as the fast tag, which is used to collect payment. Used to collect payment in national highway tolls. Vehicle violating red signals are scanned using UHF reader, and information is gathered in the software. The number plate of the vehicle is captured for image processing. Both information are compared and verified. And as soon as the verified information matches, an SMS is sent to the concerned owner of the vehicle for penalty. So this is the technology stack. So this is the working. Currently, government has made FASTag mandatory for all vehicles. FASTag is an RFID system that uses unique ID for each vehicle. Whenever the red signal is on, the RFID scanner starts scanning. If any vehicle crosses the signal, the scanner reads the tag of the concerned vehicle. In our project, we are using UHF ultra high frequency reader that is capable of reading maximum range of 20 meter with a frequency of 980 MHz with 4.6 GHz. So the image processing is worked as follows. An image of the vehicle is captured once, the reader recognizes a tag. The image captured is for evidence, and for the same image, the vehicle number is traced. image processing. The image of number plate is processed using open source package called Automatic Number Plate Recognition. This number is verified with information from the RFID. And immediately, a message will be generated to the violator and it is sent with a web link to pay the fine. So this is our project, sir. So here's a small video representing our this project, sir. Here, the car violates the red signal. As soon as the car violates the red signal, the RFID scans the RFID tag and the image is taken. These are the details fetched by RFID scanner. And this is the photo captured by the CCTV camera. So after verifying these two details, SMS is sent immediately to the owner of the vehicle who violated the red signal. So this is the SMS. So this is the website link. Here we can pay the fine amount directly. So this is the website link we generated for paying the fine. So advantages of our project is it reduces the red signal violation. So the traffic police is not needed on the spot. Reduces unwanted traffic jams and easy way of paying penalty. Thank you, sir.
Okay, I have three questions. What is the name of that animating software you are using for car simulation and then you are sure some red light, something like that?
Yes, sir.
What is the name of that animating software?
Sir, Synfix Studio and After Effects, sir.
Okay. Whether those softwares installed in mobile app, as a mobile app or in your system?
Sir, system, sir.
System, PC software, so further you need a system, right? Okay. So, whether you have any mobile phone app interface for this?
Yes, sir. We have designed a website, and that website is linked. That website, you can open it in your phone or lap anything, sir.
Okay. Whether this one is your website or you have
some? It's completely made by us, sir. It is made by us, sir.
The Phonix.
Yeah, yes, sir. It is the name which we have given, sir.
Phonix is the main domain. Okay, so you bought a domain, own domain. You have own domain.
It's a free domain. We have used a free domain, sir.
So free domain always comes with subdomain, right?
Yes, sir. Okay. And we have Razorpay site, sir, so that you can get the things. We have for payment gateway, we have used Razorpay, sir. In that, okay, we have created the project name as Phonix, sir, so that you will be getting like the Phonix name, sir,
okay,
in the domain.
Okay, so whether the software you are using for animation, whether it is a proprietary software or free open source?
Yeah, it's a proprietary software.
So Synfig is open source, sir.
And After Effects is the proprietary software, sir, which we should pay for it, sir.
Proprietary software? No, the Simulity software is a proprietary software. Whether it's open source or free source or...
Synfig is open source, sir.
Okay.
But After Effects is alone famous.
Okay, right. So participants, do you have any questions?
Sir, can I?
Yeah, you can ask.
சார் ஆக்சுவலி அண்ணா எங்க அப்பா வந்து ஆர்டிஓ டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்ல வேலை பாக்குறாருன்னா
ஓகே
ஆக்சுவலி இப்ப வர எல்லா நம்பர் பிளேட்லயும் ஒரு கியூஆர் கோட் இருக்குண்ணா இப்ப வந்து நீங்க வந்து வண்டி ரூல்ஸை மீறி போகும்போது நீங்க வண்டியை ஸ்டாப் பண்ணணும்ன்றதெல்லாம் இல்ல போலீஸ் கையில வந்து ஒரு கன்மாவ ஸ்கேனர் இருக்கும் அந்த ஸ்கேனரை வந்து அவங்க அந்த கியூஆர் மேல பிளேஸ் பண்ணாவே போதும் நீங்க சொன்ன அதே சிஸ்டம் தான் அங்கேயே ஃபாலோ பண்றாங்க ஸோ இதுக்கு அதுக்கு என்ன வித்தியாசம்
ஓகே இப்போ நீ சொன்ன உங்க அப்பா வந்து கையில ஒரு கன் மாதிரி வச்சு பாத்துருப்பாருண்ணா எல்லாத்தையும் உங்க அப்பாவால இல்ல ஒரு பத்து பேர் ஒரு இப்போ ஒரு பெரிய டிராபிக் சிக்னல் வச்சுக்கோ சென்னையில இருக்க சென்னையில எல்லா பக்கமும் ஒரு ஃபோர் வேர் ஃபைவ் வேர் இருக்குன்னு வச்சுக்கோ எல்லா பக்கமும் போலீஸ் ஸ்கேன் பண்ண முடியாது எத்தனை பேர் வயலேட் பண்றாங்கன்னா அதே சமயம் இப்போ ஒருத்த வந்து அந்த வயலேட் பண்றான் கிட்ட வந்துட்டான் நம்ம போலீஸ் வந்தாங்கன்னா உடனே வேகமா எஸ்கேப் போயிடுவான் கரெக்டா அதனால அவங்களுக்கும் ஏதாவது இடிச்சிட்டானா பிரச்சனையா போயிடும் அதாவது ஃப்ரெண்டோட அப்பாவுக்கு இந்த மாதிரி இடிச்சாங்க ஒரு அவர் போலீஸா இருக்காரு அவருக்கு வந்து ஒரு ப்ராப்ளம் வந்துச்சு அவர் கை உடஞ்சிருச்சுனால அவர் அந்த இடிச்சு போனாரு அதுக்குள்ள அவன் வந்து இடிச்சுட்டு போயிட்டான் சோ அப்பதான் நாங்க பண்ணலாம் அப்படிங்கிற ஐடியா வந்துச்சு உங்களுக்கு
ஆனா இப்ப எனக்கு ஒரு டவுட் என்னன்னா நீங்க ஆர்எஃப்டிஐ ஸ்கேனர் சொன்னீங்களா பிகாஸ் ஸ்கேனர்னாவே அது வந்து ஒரு சென்சிட்டிவான காம்போனன்ட் இப்ப வந்து நீங்க வந்து அந்த இதுல பிளேஸ் பண்ணிருக்கீங்க இப்ப வச்சு நம்ம வச்சிருக்கிற அந்த டைரக்ஷன் போர்ட்ஸ் கண்ணா பின்னா நடுவாங்க வெதருக்காக இந்த ஸ்கேனர்ஸ்க்கு வெதர் ப்ரூஃப் அந்த மாதிரி ஏதாவது இருக்குமானா
நம்ம இது இருக்கு இல்ல நம்ம இது யூஸ் பண்ணும் போது நம்ம இது வெதர் ப்ரூஃப்னா எதுவும் சொல்ல முடியாது அதாவது ரெயின் இதெல்லாம் எதுவுமே ஆகாது அதுக்கு நம்ம அதுக்கு ஏத்த மாதிரி சீல் பண்ணிருக்கணும் வெளியில பர்ஃபெக்டா சீல் பண்ணி நம்ம வச்சிருந்தோம்னா அந்த பிரச்சனை இருக்காது இது வந்து ரேடியோ ஃப்ரீக்வன்சியை டிரான்ஸ்மிட் பண்ணும் உள்ளார ஒரு டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டர் இருக்கும் அது வந்து அந்த ஃப்ரீக்வன்சியை டிரான்ஸ்மிட் பண்ணும் உனக்கு டேக்ல பட்ட உடனே வந்து ரிட்டர்ன் ஒரு ஃப்ரீக்வன்சி வரும் அந்த ஃப்ரீக்வன்சி மேட்ச் ஆச்சுன்னா நம்ம கண்டுபிடிச்சிடலாம் டேட்டாவை என்ன வந்து அப்படின்னு
பட் ஆக்சுவலி இப்போ நீங்கள் சொன்னீங்கன்னா ஆக்சுவலி வந்து இதுக்கு எதுவும் ஸ்பீட் லிமிட் இருக்காங்க அதாவது இந்த ஸ்பீடுக்குள்ளே போனால் மட்டும் அந்த சென் இதால் ஆர்எஃப்டிஐல அந்த சென்சரால அந்த கோடை ஸ்கேன் பண்ண முடியும் சப்போஸ் அந்த ஸ்பீடுக்கு மேலே இருந்துச்சுன்னா அதாவது ஸ்கேன் பண்ண முடியாது அந்த மாதிரி ஸ்பீட் லிமிட் இருக்காங்க அதுக்கு
ஸ்பீட் லிமிட் இருக்குடா அதாவது வந்து நம்ம ரொம்ப ஃபாஸ்ட்டாக போனால் ரீட் பண்ண முடியாது எதாலையுமே ரீட் பண்ணுவோம்
ஓகேண்ணா ஓகேண்ணா
நம்ம வந்து ரொம்ப ஹை டிராஃபிக் இருக்க ஏரியாவில் யூஸ் பண்ணுறதுனால அவ்வளோ ஸ்பீட் அந்த இடத்துல போகவே முடியாது
ஓகேண்ணா ஓகே
நீங்க வந்து ஒரே ஒரு கேமரா மட்டும் மேல வச்சிருந்தீங்க
அந்த போஸ்ட்ல
வரிசை எல்லா நம்பரும் நமக்கு வேல்யூ வந்துடும் அதே சமயம் RFID டேக்லயும் நமக்கு அந்த மாதிரி வேல்யூ வரும் சிக்னல் வந்து ரெட்டிங்கலா இருந்துச்சுன்னா உனக்கு ஆர்எஃப்ஐடில இருந்து ஒரு சிக்னல் வரும் அது ரெண்டையும் கம்பேர் பண்ணி உனக்கு டேட்டாபேஸ்க்கு போய் டேட்டாபேஸ்ல இருந்து உனக்கு வந்து ஒரு எஸ்எம்எஸ் சென்ட் ஆகும் ஓகேவா இந்த வெப்சைட்ல இருந்து அந்த வெப்சைட் அந்த எஸ்எம்எஸ் கிளைண்ட் யூஸ் பண்ணிருப்போம் அந்த கிளைண்ட் மூலியமா உனக்கு வந்து ஒரு மெசேஜ் வரும் இந்த மாதிரி நீங்க வயலேட் பண்ணிட்டீங்க உங்க வண்டி நம்பரோட வந்திருக்கும் அதை நீ கிக் கொடுத்த அப்படின்னா மெயின் பே பண்ணிக்கலாம் அதோட டீடைல்ஸ்னா போலீஸ்க்கும் போயிடும்
ஆனா இப்ப சப்போஸ் அவர் வந்து இப்ப வந்து அந்த யூசர் வந்து ஃபைன் பே பண்ணல அப்படின்னா என்னன்னா ஆகும்
ஃபைன் பே பண்ணனா உங்களோட இதுல தானே இருக்கும் உங்களுக்கு வந்து அதுக்கப்புறம் கேஸ் ஃபைல் பண்ணலாம் நம்ம கிட்ட போலீஸ் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் இருக்குல்ல இத்தனை பேர் இன்னும் ஃபைன் பே பண்ணல அப்படின்னு அந்த நம்பர் பிளேட் டீடைல்ஸ் இருக்குல்ல
ஆமா
இப்போ நார்மல்
ஐடியானா என்னால சொல்ல முடியாது ஆக்சுவலி நான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இயர் தான் உங்களோட ஜூனியர் தான் இருந்தாலும் ஐ மீன் மை பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் வியூல சொல்றேன் நீங்க வந்து இதுல வந்து இன்னொரு ஃபியூச்சர் மட்டும் ஆட் பண்ணிக்கலாம் எப்படின்னா ஆக்சுவலி ஐ மீன் இப்ப ஒரு டிராக் ஐ மீன் நான் தேனில இருந்து வரேன்றனால நான் அந்த ஏரியா வச்சு சொல்றேன் இப்ப வந்து பஸ் ஸ்டாப் இருக்கிற சிக்னல் ஒருத்தர் வயலேட் பண்ணிட்டாரு அவன் மேல ஒரு ஃபைன் சார்ஜ் ஃபைன் ஷீட் வந்து சார்ஜ் ஆயிடுச்சு இன்னொரு இடத்துலயும் அப்படி ஸ்கேன் பண்ணும் போது ஐ மீன் அவர் டிராபிக் ரூல்ஸே ஒபே பண்ணி போனாலும் அந்த இடத்துல ஸ்கேன் பண்ணும் போது இவர் மேல ஃபைன் இருக்குன்றத வந்து அங்க இருக்கிற கண்ட்ரோல் பூத்துக்கோ எதுக்கோ இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் போற மாதிரி இருந்தா நல்லா இருக்கும்
பண்ணிக்கலாம்டா அது ஃபர்தர் நம்ம ஃபர்தர் செட்ஸ்ல ஆட் பண்ணிக்கலாம்
ஓகேண்ணா ஓகே தேங்க் யூண்ணா நைஸ் ஃபார் தி
ஆர்டர்ஸ்ண்ணா ஓகேண்ணா எனி अदर क्वेश्चंस
தேங்க் யூ சஞ்சய் தேங்க் யூ ஓகே
யா ஓகே
அண்ட் தென் வாட் Siji, you please share your document. Are you in the meeting? Are you in the meeting? Where? You please share your for other one my okay for the other one myself and my project okay, we are ready, 12th batch. Then Pranav, you share your screen.
Yes sir, sure sir, can I?
You start your presentation.
Yes sir. Sir, is my screen visible, sir?
No, it's not visible.
Now, sir?
Yeah, now it is visible.
Yes, sir. Thanks, sir.
Panic switch.
Shall I start, main, sir?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Actually, we are from Dr. Mahalingam College of Engineering and Technology. My team name is Technofreaks, and my team members are Rishikeshwan, Vijay, and Gokul. We all are first year mechatronics batch students. We started our college this year, and we are happy to be here for presenting our project. Let's move into the topic, sir. Okay, sir, the problem we'd undertaken is woman safety, sir, because according to the census of 2016, more than 180 girls and women are being kidnapped in India every day. Almost most of them are harassed and laid into death, and only if 80 kidnaps are done, in that only 2 or 3 is for money and other is for only harassment purpose. To stop such incidents, we took an initiative and we designed a device called Panic Switch. Our objective, sir, our main objective is to reduce the rate of kidnapping and harassment against women, and to rescue the victim within a shorter period of time, sir. So the actually our Panic Switch is nothing but a combination of two devices. It's particularly an SOS device, I mean a signal, emergency signal emitter, and also a personalized GPS tracker, sir. On activating the device, the rescue team will easily get to know the live location and rescue the victim without any harm, sir. And also our project we designed in such a way it is easily hideable and user friendly and smaller in size, sir, because we designed in such a way because there's a purpose, sir. If it's a planned kidnapping or maybe unplanned kidnapping, okay, sir. In both the cases, they may be throwing off their phones, mobile phones, because of getting caught, like shown in many of the
sir?
Movies. After being kidnapped, their mobile phones will be taken away. Sir, the components we used for our project is Node MCU with firmware based on ESP8266-12E Node GPS module, LiPo battery 3.7 volt 5000 mAh, and a receiver component we are used as Raspberry Pi Zero and a 3.5 inch TFT LCD touchscreen display and a Pi Sugar battery, 3.7 volt, 1200 mAh. This battery is particularly used because this is particularly made for a Raspberry Pi Zero. This is the work function and a block diagram of the project. Actually, first on the left side, it is actually the event of activation. Panic switch in the first block, the panic switch is activated by a woman being kidnapped. When a woman or a girl. They are walking somewhere. If they are strangers, call out pandra maari irundha they are feeling to be kidnapped by unknown people, they can activate the device. The signal emitter will emit the emergency signal, and GPS module in that our Neo 6M GPS module will send the live location data. The SOS signal and location data is received and transceiver by the rescue team, and the live location is displayed on the display, sir. Okay. By using that data, the rescue team can easily track down the team and without any harm they can retrieve them. Okay, sir. On the right side of the screen, we have given that basic function. Our what functions? Okay, when the switch is activated, actually we have used a micro switch here. Switch is activated and the switch the connection is completed between Neo 6M module and Node MCU. So the data transfer of Neo 6M is actually a GPS module with a satellite antenna. okay, that will transfer our location data to the NOD MCU. Actually, NOD MCU is nothing but a Wi-Fi push. In this case, we have altered it to some case and we have made it into something that gives the location, the transfer of location data from NEO model. That NEO NOD MCU will transfer the data to our Raspberry Pi Zero. Raspberry Pi Zero will display the location data on our screen, so that we can easily track down the victim where they are. Sir, actually we used Python codes for programming this. Actually, the code is done with the help of our teacher, Mr. M. Pandi, Department of Computer Science, Dr. Mahalingam College of Engineering. He helped us in Python programming. And yes, of course, to say that merits of our device is they are smaller in size and can be easily hidden anywhere by the user. Single user systems and user friendly. They can transfer data at a rapid speed and ahead of all existing systems. Because while we are making these projects, many of them asked this kind of applications already exist, like Kavalan app, many things exist. And even in Amazon, we have finding that GPS keychains and GPS lock. Okay, that first thing I'm willing to say is that already, as I told already, if a person is being kidnapped, or maybe it's a planned or unplanned, the culprit or the kidnapper will first take away their cell phones, because that is the easiest way of getting caught. So that they will first take off their electronic bikes. But as the device is very small and easily hideable, they can easily hide it in their body, inside their dresses, in shoes, slippers. Maybe even they can use it as their lockets, keychains, etc. So it's but the only demerit we faced is less affordable, because the cost is little more expensive. We are working on that to reduce the cost of production. Actually, this is our experimental setup. Actually, some parts are not available due to the COVID situation. We have completed the transmitter successfully, but we are unable to do trans receiver, as the Pi Zero, there is no stock available in our market due to COVID situation. Actually, I have altered a old Nokia 00 phone. It's into a panic switch case. Okay, we have heat sealed it. Every circuit is placed inside and heat sealed completely. And I have connected it to my smartphone using my mobile. I have named that as a Beacon One test. That location, when I activated that, it immediately showed me the location with an alarm. The person in danger. Result: the prototype worked and the victim location is known successfully. Okay, here's a demo video for you all. Okay, here are some references. First of all, we referred a book by Nikhil Shukala, 71 Electrical and Electronic Projects for Beginners and Intermediate Engineering Students. And also the book by S.A. Khan, Mini and Major Electronic Projects. And some of them we mentioned, we have referred Google patents and also some of Raspberry organizations. And finally, we got help from a person from YouTube. He made a car tracking system, and this was our core idea, and we got his idea. Thank you, people. Thank you for listening. Any queries, please?
Pranav Kumar, you are studying first year mechatronics. Pranav Kumar, you are studying first year mechatronics?
Yes, sir. First year mechatronics. All my team is first year mechatronics.
All your teammates are first year mechatronics. Okay, very good, very good. Who are your two teammates? Pranav Kumar, Gogul?
Rishikeshwan, Vijay, myself and Gogul, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, participants, do you have any questions? Yesterday itself, Saturday night itself, we have discussed about your project, Ilya, Pranav Kumar. Saturday night we have discussed about your project report, demo and video,
yes,
all
sir,
those
yes,
things.
Sir,
okay.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Participants,
yes,
do you have any questions? Participants, other than your teammates, Nivedita is here, Parvata Reddy is here, Anthony Sagarika is here. Yeah, anyone of you having questions?
No, sir, no, sir.
Okay, right. So, Sushant Charnachalam, the batch that is going to present in the afternoon. The results will be announced at the evening around 4 p.m. And then, who is left? Veltech University.
Yes, sir.
Whether you are available?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Share your screen and present.
Okay.
Start your presentation.
Sir, thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Pranav. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Our design title is on medical applications based on wireless sensor networks, and we prepared a PPT. We three of us, Navita, me, and Shravani. This will be included in the PPT. First of all, the aim and motivation of our PPT came from monitoring the movement of the patient and heartbeat of the patient. And temperature continuously. We referred some of the algorithms. Based on that, we implemented some useful algorithms by using those. The algorithms used in existing models are complex, and some of those need some certain mobile apps, which has various drawbacks. The person who is sick also need to install that app, and the doctor also need to install that app. We replaced the uses of module like Bluetooth with the ESP8266 because of it extends up to 300 meters of range. Some of the advantages of our project include the replacing of Bluetooth with next module like ESP8266. We need an efficient design based on wireless sensor network for monitoring the patient heart condition along with the temperature, heartbeat, so that we can come to know that patient is not in danger and he's safe. This is the literature review we took from IEEE papers. The methodology included in this is the accelerometer is connected to the Arduino Uno and a temperature sensor and a heartbeat, and ASP8266 is connected. Accordingly, we'll get the outputs on the web page. A buzzer and LED also helps for the person who is near, so that we can immediately take care of the person. We use three algorithms. One is blood pressure monitoring algorithm, a temperature algorithm, and movement detection algorithm. This algorithm includes blood pressure monitoring algorithm includes, we made a code in Arduino so that if the person has the blood pressure less than, blood pulses per minute less than 60, that message will be conveyed to the particular receptionist or the doctor. And the temperature algorithm also, if there is a high temperature detected, that message will be sent to the particular person. And the movement detection algorithm also, we included instead of accelerometer, we included a potentiometer, as you can see in the circuit diagram here. This is a demo of the project. I wish to play this, sir.
Yeah, proceed.
And reopen the Proteus software. And the Proteus software, I'm going to add the HTML that I'm creating. are in the same heat trial in the previous academy. Now, extra lab, the heartbeat sensor heat trial, which is already in, which I have already included. And next, I am going to tell what are all the components in the and I am going to tell what are the components in the first of all, I have included the accelerometer and then we included the temperature sensor and the heartbeat sensor. The heartbeat sensor is also on the box and the principle of the potential meter working only. You can see there is oscillator and the video does that. If there are any danger of the siren, as you can see, after simulating it, we get the virtual terminal and the digital oscilloscope. Here, the virtual terminal output is nothing but the VSP to the digits output. As you can see, if there is no temperature, that means that there is less temperature, normal temperature, there is a normal reading as shown. And the normal movement as shown. If the potentiometer reading is varied, that means if the patient has fell down, if it is zero angle, we'll get that the patient is in danger as shown in the ESP to the visit. And we can also see that the LED is glowing. The LED glowing shows that the siren will get on if the patient is in danger condition. And if we see the potentiometer angle is zero, that represents the patient is in zero angle, and we continue that he is in danger. And after that, I am going to show the output of the heartbeat sensor. If I click on the reset button, it will get resetted, and I am going to change the value of the pulses that the heartbeat sensor is in. I'm going to safety check 200 nanoseconds in the oscilloscope later. And if we see if the heartbeat is proper, if the heartbeat rate is proper, that means 60 to 80, we can get that the patient is in safe. And if the temperature is high or something, then we can say that the patient is in danger. Now I'm going to show you if the patient is in zero, if the patient fell down, or if the patient had the bridge stops, it will get recorded in the digital oscilloscope. As you can see, we can monitor via this and the ESP to the basics.
Sir, that's the demo part, sir. And coming to the result and analysis part, we can monitor the heartbeat temperature as well as the movement of the patient separately.
Anthony Sagarika, I want one clarification. What is this software, whether it's a lab view or what?
Proteus software, sir.
Okay. Proteus. Okay. Whether this one is a proprietary software, this one is a proprietary software, okay?
Yes, sir.
This is not free software, okay? Whether you have a
No, sir. We can access without having license also, sir. There is no need of license. It is open software, sir.
No, it's not open source.
Yes, sir. We have done...
your staff member may have this original version. Okay.
Sir, for having certain libraries, we need to buy those, sir. For certain Adafruit libraries, we need to buy, sir.
Okay.
These are all the things I found in the Proteus software only, sir.
Okay.
Whatever we included in this, we all got from the GitHub website only, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. In this manner, we can see the values. If the system is placed in the reception side, we can see the recent movements of the patient and recent consumptions of the patient also. We can extend further this to the artificial intelligence side also, including certain things and involving signal processing systems also. And the conclusion is this Wi-Fi module extends up to 400 meters, whereas the GSM and Bluetooth can't. The practical application of the system will help in certain rural areas also. And these are the references part. We took them from IEEE papers, sir, a sensor network based health monitoring system. and a wireless sensor network protocol for patient monitoring system, and a smart configuration Wi-Fi technology using ESP8266 and all IP wireless sensor networks and wireless patient monitoring systems. That's all, sir. Thank you, sir. If anyone has doubt, you can ask me.
Okay, no doubt in it. Okay, okay, right. So you all the things you have simulated.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Okay. What did you try it in hardware?
No, sir. Just we want to buy certain components, sir. We kept order and we have to do it them, sir, practically.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, sir.
Okay. The results will be announced around 4 o'clock today. For internal participants, even though two third year and second year, Harish and Amrish, they have a cost effective project, but it is not possible to give them prize money. They may get honorable mention, but the first prize, second prize, third prize, all those things for only external participants only, for not for internal participants. And the first prize, second prize, third prize will be announced around 4 p.m. today evening. Only one batch is left. Sushant Arunachalam from Rajalakshmi Institute of Technology, she asked for permission today. She is having some exam in the forenoon session. Only one batch is left. That is going to be conducted around 2 p.m. today afternoon. Thank you. Thank you, participants. Remaining thing we will discuss in the WhatsApp. Yeah.
Can I join that meeting also, sir?
Yeah, you can join.
The products are very nice. If I ask some doubts to them, I also will clarify.
Okay. No problem. No problem. All the participants, they can join the afternoon meeting also. No problem. We will have some WhatsApp communication. The certificates, the certificates will be issued on Thursday, 20th Thursday. And the prize money will be distributed 29th Friday, 29th January, sir. Friday.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
And also, sir, to mention, actually, this project is made in one night, sir.
Okay. Those things we discussed in the Saturday itself. Okay. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your support, sir.
Thank you. Rejoin at 2 p.m. today afternoon.
Okay, sir. Sure, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah,
I have only one doubt, sir.
Okay.
Ask you, sir.
Yeah, you can ask.
Then what kind of evaluate pandranga, sir, juries?
Yeah, based on your presentation and how much your project you have completed. Whether it is cost effective, neatness of your project report.
Okay, sir.
All those things.
Not of our presentation only, sir.
No, we should consider all those things. Sometimes you may have some internet problem, or you may have some laptop may be shut down, or your software may not work, or you cannot be able to share your video, some problem, something like that. So we have to consider all those things, report, presentation, and your shared video, how much project you have completed, whether it is practically feasible or not. All those projects are practically feasible, okay. And then cost, whether it is cost effective or not.
Okay, sir. That's all, sir.
Okay.
Thank you for doing this opportunity, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Langadhan. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, CG Celsius, that is sufficient. Celsius, that is sufficient. Okay, okay. That is enough. I got your photo in my WhatsApp. Okay, okay. Okay, no problem. Okay, okay. No problem, no problem. சரி ரைட்டு சரிம்மா ரைட் ஓகே இது பார்த்தலாம் அது பார்த்துக்கலாம் ஒன்றும் அதெல்லாம் ஒன்றும் பிரச்சனை இல்லை அது ஒன்றும் பிரச்சனை இல்லை அவ்வளோ அது ஒரு ஒரு இது கொஞ்சம் போதும் ரைட் ஓகே ஓகே ரைட் ஓகே ரைட் தேங்க்யூ தேங்க்யூ